Assalamu alaikum, good morning. I'm Mrs. Afshin Imran, your English teacher. I'm going to give you a lecture of English literature today. In the first lecture, I have discussed about the introduction of the novel, introduction of the writer, as well as introduction of the characters. So, in this lecture, I'm going to start the explanation of lesson one. Are you hearing me all? Okay. Reply, please. Are you hearing me? Okay, very good of you. You all are here. Okay, I understand you are here. Now concentrate on your lecture. I will give you last 5 or 10 minutes to ask any question or to solve the confusions. I'm going to start the explanation of lesson one today. Okay. Now, I think all of you are here, almost all of you are here. So, I'm going to start the explanation of lecture one today. Lesson one today. Okay. I hope you have done the reading of lesson one. This is lecture two of literature and it is about lesson one, Bad Tom. Okay. I have already told you about Tom, about his behavior, about his some habits, about his character, that Tom was a very mischievous boy. His parents had died. He lived with his Aunt Polly. He did not want to go to school or church. So you have known some of the characteristics of Tom Sawyer. Now I come to your lesson and I'm telling you that I will read the lesson page wise and then I will explain as well as I will tell you about some summary of the pages one by one. Okay. So listen to my reading very carefully. Some of the words, how I pronounce those words, and I will have underlined. I have underlined some of the words in all the pages, like you can see that here. So you have to find their meanings and note down in the rough notebook so that whenever you read the lesson again, then you will understand more. Now, don't write anything. Don't disturb the class. Try to understand and listen to me very carefully. Concentrate on the lecture. At last, before 10 minutes or 5 minutes, I will give you a chance to ask me questions. Okay, now listen to me very carefully. The lesson is Bad Tom and its part one is Tom must be punished. And please don't disturb the class. Tom shouted Aunt Polly. There was no answer. It means Aunt Polly was calling Tom, but Tom was not giving any answer. Tom, she called again, but there was still no reply. It means no answer again. Where is that boy, Tom? She was asking herself, where is him? And she shouted louder than before. She was calling Tom a little louder, but no answer again. She took off her glasses and looked around the room. She was wearing, I said, glasses, and she took them off and then looked around the room. She wanted to find Tom. Then she stood up and went to the open door. She looked out over the garden. No Tom. Now she went near the garden, and from the open door, she saw that Tom was not in the garden as well. You, Tom, again she was calling him. There was a noise behind her, and she turned round quickly. Suddenly, she heard a noise behind her. She turned round very quickly, and she saw that she was just in time to catch hold of a small boy by the back of his trousers. What happened? Tom was behind her, and he was hiding himself, but he wanted to run away. But at the same moment, Aunt Polly turned around and caught him. I had forgotten that cupboard, she said. She was saying about the cupboard that she had forgotten it. What have you been doing in there? Nothing. Now, she was asking Tom what he was doing inside the cupboard. He replied, nothing. Nothing? Just look at your hands and mouth. What is that mess? Now, Aunt Polly saw his hands and mouth. His hands and mouth were dirty. So she was asking, what was it? I don't know, Aunt. He replied, he don't know. He didn't know. Well, I know. It's jam. Aunt said, you don't know, but I know that it's jam. That's what it is. You have been in that cupboard eating jam. I understood, Aunt Polly said, that she understood that Tom was eating jam in the cupboard. I have told you so many times to leave that jam alone. She told Tom that she had not allowed Tom to eat the jam, and she had told him to leave it. Give me that stick. Now she was asking for her stick. She wanted to punish Tom and beat him with the stick. Now you can see the picture that Aunt Polly was asking Tom, and behind it you can see the cupboard. Inside, jam was present. Now I come to the short explanation, or you can say the summary, of page number 1, as well as the background of the story. Okay, I'm telling you a little bit background as well. Tom was a mischievous boy. Mischievous means very naughty. He disturbed other people and played tricks on them. He wanted to disturb other people. He enjoyed in disturbing the people and playing tricks with them. His parents had died. He lived with his Aunt Polly along with his brother Sid and his sister Mary. Aunt Polly was actually the sister of his mother. They all lived in a village of St. Petersburg near Mississippi River. Okay, that was the name of the village, and it was not a big one, it was a small village. Ariba, if you want to ask anything, ask at the end or right here in the chat. No, it is not the real story, but some part of it is real. Okay, now I continue my lecture. One day, Tom hid somewhere and Aunt Polly called him. Whatever I have explained, it is written over here. Tom hid somewhere inside the cupboard. You can see that in the picture you have seen, as well as you have read it here. He did not reply when Aunt Polly was calling him, as he was eating jam in the cupboard. Why he was not replying, he was not answering? Because he was eating jam and he did not want Aunt Polly to see him. Aunt Polly called him again and again, but he did not answer. Suddenly, Aunt Polly heard a noise behind her and she caught him near the cupboard. Okay? Because of the noise, Aunt Polly saw her and caught him. She understood that Tom was eating jam. She scolded him for that and asked for her stick. Okay, very good, Shahir. You have read this story, but now concentrate on the lecture and listen to me very carefully. Listen how I pronounce the words when I am reading. Now we come to page number 2. If you remember, Aunt Polly was asking for a stick. The stick was held up high. Tom really was in trouble. Now Aunt Polly wanted to beat him. And Tom understood that he was in trouble. So, oh, look behind you, Aunt, shouted Tom. So, Tom was thinking about a trick and he got an idea. And he suddenly shouted, Aunt, look behind you. The old lady turned round to see what the matter was. She was confused and suddenly turned around. This gave Tom time to jump up. This was the enough time for Tom to jump up. He had climbed over the high wooden fence and was out of sight before his aunt knew what was happening. What happened during that moment when Aunt Polly turned around? He jumped up and climbed over the fences and ran away. And then he was out of sight till Aunt Polly knew what was happening to her. Now, when Tom was gone, Aunt Polly understood that and she stood surprised for a minute. Then she began to laugh. She began to laugh at herself because she understood that Tom had played a trick on her. Oh, that boy. She said to herself, he's played so many tricks on me. Like that. She understood that. And she was saying to herself, I should have been ready for him. She said that because Tom was playing tricks on her, so she should be ready every time. He'll stay away from school this afternoon. I know, so I will have to make him work tomorrow. She was deciding about the punishment for Tom, that his school will be off next day. So she wanted to give him some work or doing on the holiday. And it was actually to punish him. It's very hard to make him work on Saturdays when all his friends are having a holiday. She also knew that it's a difficult task to give him any work to do on Saturday because it was a holiday and all the friends are enjoying on that day. He hates work more than anything else, but I shall have to punish him somehow. Now, she also knew that Tom hated to do any work. He just wanted to enjoy but Aunt Polly decided that she would give punish to Tom. Next part of the lesson is the fight. Tom walked down the street practicing a new way to whistle. He was roaming here and there aimlessly and he was practicing a new tune of whistle. It made a very good sound and he had only just learned how to do it. He was practicing a new tune. But what happened? Suddenly he stopped whistling. In front of him stood a boy a little taller than himself. Tom had never seen him before. There was a boy standing in front of Tom. He was a little bit taller than himself and Tom had not seen him in the village before. Tom was surprised to see him. Actually, the village of St. Petersburg was a very small one where Tom lived with his Aunt Polly, his brother Sid, and Mary. his sister. Mary was his sister and Sid was his brother. Was a small, quiet place. Now, St. Petersburg was a small, quiet place. You did not often see new people there. Actually, there are many little number of people living there. So, every people knew other people. This boy was well-dressed too. It was not Sunday and he was well-dressed, which was very unusual. Now, Tom was surprised to see his new clothes or neat and clean clothes. Why he was well-dressed? It was a holiday. He even wore a tie. He was wearing a tie as well. So, Tom stared at him, looking at him continuously. And the longer he stared, the dirtier his own clothes seemed. When he was looking continuously at him, he was comparing his clothes with his own clothes, which are very dirty. The boy was wearing neat and clean clothes. So Tom did not like that. And because of that, he hated that boy. Neither boy spoke. No one was speaking. If one moved, the other moved sideways. Both of the boys were looking at each other. They circled around one another. They were moving around each other. And face to face, eye to eye, all the time, they were looking at each other. And there was a continuous eye to eye contact, but they were not talking to each other. Now you can see that I have underlined some of the words here in this page also, so that you will find the meanings here. Now I'm telling you the short explanation of page 2 again here. Aunt Polly wanted to beat Tom with the stick. If you remember that she wanted the stick because Tom had eaten the jam from the cupboard and Tom was in great trouble because he wanted to beat him. He thought for a trick. He shouted to Aunt to look behind her. He suddenly shouted so that Aunt became confused and looked around. Aunt Polly got confused and turned round. Tom jumped up and climbed over the wooden fence and ran. Okay? Now, there is another part of page 2. About the boy, new boy. Aunt Polly understood that Tom had played a trick on her. She wanted to give him punish. She decided to give him some work to do on Saturday as it was a holiday. Actually, Tom did not like to do any work, and Saturday was also a holiday and it was the enjoyment day for other boys. But because of Tom's bad behavior, she decided to give him punish on Saturday to do some work. Tom walked down the street, practicing a new way to whistle. He was roaming here and there, and suddenly he saw a boy in front of him. He did not know that boy because he had not seen him before in the village. He was well-dressed and even wore a tie. Tom hated that boy because he was very neat and clean, and Tom was wearing dirty clothes. Tom stared at him as he himself was in dirty clothes. Now I come to the next page, page number 3. Here it is written at the top, page number 3. At last, Tom spoke. Now the boys who were staring at each other, they started speaking. I can beat you. I would like to see you try it. Well, I can. No, you can't. Yes, I can. No, you can't. I can. You can't. Can. You can see there is a long conversation between both the boys, and they were actually threatening each other that Tom can beat that boy or that boy can beat Tom. After that conversation, there was an uncomfortable silence. They stopped talking again. Then Tom said again, "What's your name?" Tom was asking his name. "It is not your business," he said. "It's not your matter. Don't ask me. Well, I will make it my business. Well, why don't you? If you say much more, I will. Much more? Much more? Much more? There. Now. Oh, you think you are very clever, don't you? I could beat you with one hand tied behind my back if I wanted to. Now again, you can see that Tom was asking his name, but he did not want to tell his name to Tom. And because of that, Tom told him that he could beat him with one hand. Well, why don't you do it? You say you can do it. Well, I will if you don't watch out. Well, go on then. Why do you keep talking about it? Why do you keep saying you will? It's because you're afraid. Now the boy said, you are just saying to beat me. You are not doing it because you are afraid from me. Tom said, I'm not afraid. You are. I'm not. You are. There was another silence. Both of them said to each other that they were afraid from the other boy. Now, again, they stopped talking. And more staring at each other and moving round. Now, they were continuously looking at each other again and moving round and round. Soon, they were shoulder to shoulder. Now, they came closer to each other. Tom said, get away from here. He said, get away yourself. Now, Tom was saying to the boy to go away from that place. The boy replied the same to Tom. You can see that there is continuous conversation on this page. Okay? Dialogue by dialogue, Tom and the boy were speaking to each other. Now I come to the short explanation of this page again. Tom and the boy stared at each other. Stared means looking continuously at each other. Both of them gave threat to beat the other. They were threatening each other to beat the other. Tom asked his name. He did not answer. He did not want to tell his name to Tom. The boy said that Tom was afraid. Tom replied that the boy was afraid. Both of them were telling the other that they were afraid. Now we come to page number 4. I won't either. Both of them were saying that they were not afraid. So they stood there pushing at each other as hard as they could. In another minute, they were rolling in the dirt. What happened? They did not like each other. So they pushed each other as hard as they could. And both of them fell down and they were rolling in the dirt on the street. They pulled and tore at each other's hair and clothes. They pulled each other's clothes, hair, and tore them. Tore them, break them into pieces, tried to break them into pieces. They scratched each other's noses. They scratched the noses of other by their nails. And then they covered themselves with dust. Tom at last. They were continuously rolling on the dust, and at last Tom got on the top of the new boy, sat on him and hit him with his fist. You can see here in the picture that the strange boy was at the down or laying down under the Tom, and Tom was at the top of him and he was beating him with his fist. Okay. And he also said to the boy, say enough, he said. Now he was beating continuously and he said to the boy that you would have to say enough, then I will leave you. The boy only tried harder to get free. The boy tried harder and harder to get free from Tom. But he was very angry and his anger made him cry. He was not able to let him free from Tom. So he became angry and because of the anger, he started crying. After some time, When he tried enough, he said enough. At last, the stranger managed to whisper enough. Okay, what happened at last? The strange boy became tired and he said enough in a very low voice. That means whisper means very low voice. And then Tom let him get up. Then Tom stood up and let him get up. And then the boy had gone. Now, that will teach you, he said, you would better remember who you are talking to next time. Now, Tom was saying him when he was going that this was the lesson which I am giving you, that you had to talk to the people and think before that. Whenever you meet the new person or talk to a new person, you would think before that. Now, the fight was over, both of them gone. Now, Tom got home quite late that night. He was spending the whole day here and there, and then he returned home quite late that night. He was very late. So, he climbed quietly in through the bedroom window. He did not enter from the main door, but he entered through the bedroom window. He did not want to wake his brother Seth, who shared his room. Actually, he did not want to wake his brother Seth as well as Aunt Polly, because they would be angry. Seth was sharing his room, so he entered through the window so that there was no noise, and he did not want to wake up Aunt Polly, who was sleeping downstairs. Actually, the room of Tom and Seth was upstairs, but Tom did not know that Aunt Polly was awake. But he went to his room, but Aunt Polly was awake waiting for him. She was very angry when she saw the mess his clothes were in. She saw Tom with his dirty clothes and with the dirt. If you remember, he fought with the boy and the whole of his clothes were covered in dust and dirt and tore off as well. So she was very angry. She became very angry and she promised herself that she would make Tom's Saturday into a day of hard work. If you remember, she had decided to give the punish to Tom on Saturday, and she had to give him a lot of hard work to do on Saturday as a punishment. Now I want to discuss the last page of today's lecture in short form here. Tom asked him to get away from there. If you remember, he was fighting with the boy. Before that, he was telling him to go away from that place. He replied the same. The boy replied the same and told Tom to go away. Then they pushed each other and started fighting. They pulled each other's hair and clothes. They scratched each other's noses as well with their nails. They covered themselves with dust. At last, Tom got on top of the boy and backed him with his fist. The boy said enough, and then Tom left him because Tom was giving him the warning to say the word enough. So he said enough at last when he tried harder to be free from Tom, but at last he said enough, and then Tom left him. Then at night, Tom returned home very late at night. He entered through the bedroom window so that no one would disturb. But Aunt Polly saw the mess on his clothes and became angry. And she had decided to give him punish on Saturday, which she already decided. And now I want to tell you that I have underlined some of the words on each page. Like here, you can see that scratched and whisper, promised, okay. Now, it's your time to ask anything. If you have not understand anything, you can ask me. I have given in the last lecture the assignments of language to do. Hope you have done some part of it. I will give you written homework today about literature. And I'm telling you that you have, if you have not understood anything, any part of the lecture, then ask me in the chat. And one more thing, you have to read the lesson again in your home so that if you do not understand anything, you can understand very easily, because I have explained half part of the first lesson. Ibrahim, if you have any question, please ask me in the chat. And one more thing, that I will upload this video on the YouTube channel and I will share the link on the Google Classroom so that you will get the lecture from there and you will repeat it. Okay. This is interesting. Okay. In the first paragraph, Aunt Polly was finding Tom and Tom was hiding somewhere. Actually, he was hiding himself in the cupboard because he was eating jam there. Aunt Polly did not allow him to eat the jam, and because of that, he was hiding there. And ate jam there. Any other thing which you want to ask? I have underlined some of the words. Okay, find out their meanings in the dictionary so that you will understand those words well. I will give the written assignment today of literature. So please do the assignment in your literature copy and remember to make the index very carefully. You can make the index with blue fountain pen. You can use black pointer to write the heading. Similarly, you can use black fountain pen or black pointer to write the questions and write all answers with blue fountain pen. No marker is allowed in my English copies, both the copies, literature copy and language copy. Assignment will be uploaded on Google Classroom. So find out there what is the assignment. Do you like the story? Do the literature work in literature copy and language work in language copy. Be very careful in doing the assignments and write your roll number on the top of your copy, please. Yes, pointer is allowed. You can use black pointer only. Okay. Don't use blue pointer anywhere. Only black pointer is allowed. Okay. I will give the assignment for lesson one only because we have done it, almost half part of it has been done. So I'm giving you only the assignment about lesson number one. Now, please, students, if you have any question, you can ask me. One more thing which I want to tell you. That you have to change your ID in your Google Classroom if you are not there in with your real names. Any other question? Because almost 2 minutes are left. Yes, I will give you homework today. Dua, I will give the homework, please. You can see on the Google Classroom. Please go through it. Okay. And it will be very easy. You can do it easily, very easily. Remember to rename your IDs on Google Classroom. You don't have any question? Whose character do you like most, Aunt Polly or Tom? You have to, Aunt Polly, do you like Aunt Polly most? Okay, very good. If you want like Tom or Aunt Polly, it's up to you. Some of you like Aunt Polly and some of you like Tom. Be careful about the spelling of aunt, A-U-N-T, okay, not A-N-T. Okay, now almost the time has been finished. So I want to talk to you the last thing that you should be very careful in writing the assignment, please. Okay, do the literature work in literature copy and language work in language copy. And okay, I'm leaving here. I'm stopping my lecture. Hope you have understood very well. Now, Allah Hafiz. We will do literature lectures in the next week also. So read the lesson.